Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. We're here today with Paula Milan, who recently resigned from the Classen City Council in order to run for mayor. How are you today?
I'm very well, Crystal. Thank you for doing this and for providing this platform for people to get to know candidates who are running for local office.
Well, thank you. Can you just tell us a little bit more about how long have you been on council for and what are some of the things you're most proud of?
I've served on this council for 4 years. I recently had to resign because there's a clause in our charter that states if you are running for an office other than the one that you hold, you have to resign your seat. So the end of July, I submitted my resignation. When I submitted my ballots, my signed affidavits to run for council. So in the past 4 years, it's been there's been a lot, a lot of activity. There's been a lot of excitement for good and bad things. We endured COVID. We had a lot of staff come and go, and we just had a few issues that were really hot button issues for the community. What I'm really proud of is one, I didn't quit, and two, I feel like I represented the community with what I said I was going to represent the community with, which was just honesty, professionalism, and integrity. I asked a lot of questions. I learned a lot of things. I was on the opposing side of many, many issues. And that didn't bother me so much because it's just the process that's so interesting. I really enjoy local government. I like the idea that you bring five people with different views and histories and goals together and then hopefully come to something that is good for everyone. So I've enjoyed that process, even in the bad times. But what I'm most proud of is getting to know residents, getting to know our staff, maintaining a sense of, I would say, common sense. To me, I tried to always utilize common sense in my approach to the various issues. We had several issues that were extremely personal towards people's inclinations or goals or whatever, and I tried to just ask good questions and then in the end make my decision based on what I think is best for the community, not necessarily for the individuals. So I'm proud that I was able to do that. I was proud that I was able to withstand pressure at times from people who wanted me to cave on topics, and I think just being part of the process was really interesting for me. One issue I was really proud of is recently we had this planned unit development that came up. It was an item that over 200 residents put together a petition, put together PowerPoint presentations to the Planning Commission, presented to the City Council, and were extremely passionate about this issue, about not wanting this issue in the community. I was very proud to support them. It did pass, so we were on the losing side of that, but I was proud that we have the kind of residents that are passionate and were willing to put some skin in the game and not just show up and say, I just don't want it because I'm going to have to look at it or because it's convenient for me or not convenient for me. I really enjoyed that because they were part of the process.
So what are some of the things that you want to work on if you are elected to mayor?
I think we really need to work on bridge building, first of all, and that is having to do with the relationships throughout the community for all of our end users, right? We've had a lot of issues with staffing. I would like to instill a sense of pride and trust and commitment and acceptance of our employees, allow them to do their jobs and to do it well. I would like to work with our local businesses so that they have confidence in us as a governing body and as the city. I think some of the things that have transpired over the past couple of years it makes people wonder, you know, why am I investing here? What will I expect if I need something from City Hall? Is this place nice? Is it not nice? And nice is probably not the right word, but, you know, is it a business-friendly, people-friendly place? So I'd like to instill process. I'd like us to utilize the processes that are in place so that everybody has the same opportunity. So there are no deals that take place outside of the process, and that We can just say, this is what you have to do to get this. You follow the steps. We follow the steps. We come to the conclusion. So that would be very important to me. I think it's time to listen. I think we have, we've had some people have not had a voice in the past couple of years, and for various reasons, but I'd like it to be an open dialogue for all people, regardless of your voice or what you have to say. I just think everyone deserves to be heard. And I think we should always be respectful of other people's opinions and then, you know, allow the dialogue and hopefully come to a good place in the end. There's always someone who's not going to be happy because everyone doesn't get their own way. None of us ever do always get our own way. And I think most of us are okay with that because it's just life. But I would like, I'd just like to foster an environment where people aren't afraid to state their concerns, their opinions, their good and their bad. I would just like to foster good communication. And I think that starts with listening. And then I also think it's just time for us to act. We have a lot of concerns that people, the residents have, and we have some really difficult choices to make on how we're going to address some of these concerns. And I think we really just need to start the dialogue and bite the bullet and start addressing some of these things.
Can you tell us about your professional experience and what skills you bring to the table?
Sure. I work for an engineering firm, an architectural engineering firm. I've been there for 27 years. And my responsibilities for them, I manage their HR department. I do hiring, I do recruiting, I do benefits. So I have all of those skills. I also do purchasing. I do budgeting for projects. I am involved in specifications a lot. So I'm also familiar with zoning, and not all zoning, you know, everyone's different, but I'm familiar with some zoning and some licensing and building aspects. Just from that, I've taken a lot of continuing education on green building or on infrastructures or on sustainability, because those are all trendy in our business. And I think those are all transferable skills for the city at this point as well. And what else do I do? I work for the president, so I represent in a lot of things. I also manage the minority supplier development aspect of our business, so I'm active in that arena as well. So I have purchasing, HR, a little bit of building type experience, and also just general admin, executive, team building, bridging, and I do all of our special events. So it's a small firm, 50 people. We do a lot of volume for that, and so I have a lot of hats that I wear there. But I also have an education, which is my bachelor's degree is in political science from Oakland University, and I have a master's degree in public administration from Eastern Michigan University. So in addition to the real world skills I have that education base that gave me the interest in wanting to be part of a government.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
Well, my family and I have lived here for 9 years. I'm married. My husband is Dave. I have a daughter, Alyssa, and a son, Nicholas. We came to Clawson as a school of choice family. We lived in another community. Schools are not great there, needed a place for them to go. They were in a Christian school. We looked around at other Christian schools. And then we came to Clawson because it was school of choice. When we came here, my first person I met was Patty Pell. She was super nice, super sweet. Came back 2 weeks later with my daughter. She remembered my daughter's name. Like we had not had, there was no paperwork passed. There was nothing involved in it. It was just a really warm and inviting feeling. So we decided, my daughter decided that we would attend Shalm. So we came to Shalm and we commuted for a few years. And then we got to know people in the community. My children's friends were exceptional. Got to know their families. They were also exceptional. My son started playing sports, a little baseball and then football and whatever. So we got to know people that way. And I was just really proud of the way people were so committed to this community and they were committed to each other. So we wanted to be a part of it. So we purchased a home here. We stalked homes for a long time. It was hard to get one that we really liked, but we were really happy with our purchase. We've now been here 9 years. And that's how it started. So within my first year here, I had met Penny Lubes in baseball, or no, in Cub Scouts. That was fun too. Cub Scouts is fun. So we met her in Cub Scouts, and then she asked me shortly after moving if I would want to serve on the planning commission. So I joined the planning commission, where I served for 4 years until I had to give up my seat to run for city council. And then I ran for city council. So I have those two things as far as like official activities. But we have supported, you know, I've worked in school classrooms. We've supported the band program. We've supported all the sporting group programs my children were a part of. We've tried to be active that way, either through, you know, the donations or just putting in your time, doing whatever. I don't have any other formal things with COSM, but I've been extremely invested and busy since I've been here, just doing those other two things. And I'm proud to say that I've done it. I've learned a lot about the community. I've learned a lot about the businesses that are here. The opportunities that come through here are amazing for this 2.2 mile business community. But what we really love here are the people. It's what makes the difference in everything that transpires here.
So in this race, there are a couple people running for mayor. Why should the voters pick you?
They should pick me if they're looking for someone who has experience, who is educated, who is passionate about local government, because I truly am, and also who is committed to fostering and relationships, building bridges, and listening. I think that's my number one skill, is I generally like people. People crack me up. The nice ones, the mean ones, and the ones in between. They all crack me up. I find amusement in just getting to know where people are coming from, what makes them tick, and what they want. And I think generally I have a very good ability at building bridges and making people feel comfortable and making people feel valued. And I feel like that's kind of something that's been lost the last couple of years, is just certain people are heard, but other people have been dismissed. And I don't want to be part of a community that dismisses anyone. I think we're all worthy, or no one is better than, no one deserves more attention. And I would like to do that. But I'd also just like to kind of put the heart back into Clawson. I feel like we've had a lot of drama lately. A lot of it was well-intended, but it's taken the emphasis off of what good things can happen here. And I would just like to kind of keep it simple. I would make a good leader as far as our meetings, because technically the mayor is the same as the rest of council, except they lead the meetings and they often serve as a representative for the community. If I were elected mayor, I would like to have meetings that are a little bit more lighthearted than what we've had in the past. I would like to encourage more community participation, and I would like to share the duties with the rest of the council as far as representing the community, should COVID ever end and we actually get to do things again. But I think, everyone who's running right now has a reason they're running, right? Everyone has a commitment to this community. I think it's hard to distinguish that from anyone, because if anyone's willing to do this for what comes out of it, which is not a lot, but, you know, there's no payola, that they have a heart for it. So I have a good heart, and I have professionalism, and I just would appreciate anyone's confidence in me to carry out this task.
So if the voters want to know more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
They can go to, soon, paulamilan.com, paulamillan.com, for my website. And then I have a Facebook page, which is Paula Milan for Clawson. And you can also call me. My phone number is 248-613-8635. And I really encourage people to contact me. The people who want to support me and the people who are kind of haters, if there is such a thing, because I really value dialogue. I would like to hear what people really are interested in for this community. I know we have issues with our roads. I know we have issues with the power, the sewer system. Those are basic things, you know, that we think we should just be able to fix, but we need a process to do that. We need funding to do that. There's gonna be a lot of dialogue involved to do that. Those things are harder to fix, but the little things, such as just giving people confidence in their city services. I think we have excellent city employees. They're all invested. And I think this community has services that exceed other surrounding communities. We still offer a lot of things that other communities don't. And I think that's why people choose to live here. They like that, you know, they get their streets sweeped. and plowed, and we do the special pickup thing where they don't ask, you know, you don't have to make a call to get a couch picked up or whatever. I think all of those things are important. And I think we need to just create dialogue to ensure that we support the people who are doing those jobs, let people know what's available to them, and let them know why we can do certain things, why we can't do certain things, and then work together to try and get more things done.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to do the interview with us today.
Thank you, Crystal.